Hi guys, myself Neha Gupta. You all know me that I'm your mentor for current affairs. But those who are coming for the first time on this channel, let me introduce myself. So I have done my graduation from Lakshmibai College, Delhi University. Then I have pursued my master's from English Literature from IGNU University. And I have been a mentor of current affairs for quite a long period of time. Now let's discuss about the morning tales for October 21, 2020. So in this morning tales, I have brought to you some very important and relevant current affairs. There are very crisp news items which are from different segments of Spotlight. So we have quite a total number of 5 to 6 news which are from national segment. Then we have a news from international and then from banking and then from appointments and also from the sports section as well. So quite an important session it is going to be. So do watch this session till the end and please subscribe to this channel if you are new to this channel and hit this bell notification so that you get the instant notifications whenever we come live or we upload any kind of new videos. Also join this Telegram channel where we upload we provide free quizzes as well as connect with our students. So here it is the table of contents. Let's discuss it very quickly. So first topic is India's partnership for cooperating in the e-health sector. Then first Aerotropolis of India, first region that is going to become Aerotropolis. So what is this? That we will be discussing in the second question. Then cultivation of hing. You would be thinking that it is an irrelevant topic, but don't be mistaken here because it is not so. It is an important topic because it is the first time that hing is going to be cultivated in India. Yes, you have heard it right. Hing that is so commonly found in our kitchens is not produced in India. It is imported till date. And it is for the first time that hing is going to be produced in India itself. So what are the things that we need to cover from exam point of view? That we will be discussing in the third question. Then we have National Dairy Development Board's call center. This is also important. Then we have Australia and India and Australian Navy's military exercise. These 5 news are from the national segment of Spotlight. Then we have world's first country that has implemented facial recognition system. This is from international news. Then SEBI's Market Data Advisory Committee from banking segment that we will be discussing in 7th news, 7th question. Then we have chairman of IBA appointment section. And then we have the Denmark Open and I-League from the sports section. So this is how the session is going to be like this. So watch the session till the end and listen to me very carefully. So here comes our first question. With which country has India partnered for cooperation in the e-health sector as part of the National Digital Health Mission of India? Now guys, you would know about this National Digital Health Mission of India because it was launched on October 15 itself during the Prime Minister's Independence Day speech. So I hope that majority of you know what this National Health Digital Mission is. So basically this National Health Digital Mission aims to provide the health services and bring the health sector on the digital platform. So under this mission, what will be done under this mission? All the health services will be provided online, like consultancy, pharmacy, and all these kinds of services will be provided online. Now, this mission is covered in detail in PIB 247 session. So, if you have not seen the session, then do watch that PIB 247 session in which this National Digital Health Mission was covered. Now, what are the points that you should cover? That you should remember from this mission for the phase one examination. First point is that this mission is prepared by the J. Satyanarayan Committee. So do remember this name, J. Satyanarayan Committee. And under this mission, 4 type of services will be provided, health card and the registry of patients will be there. So all these are the things have been covered in PIB 247 session. So do watch that session. And for now, let's keep ourselves restricted to this question only because otherwise this session is going to extend for 1 hour if we go to the length of this National Digital Health Mission. So let's come back to the question itself. So the question is saying that we have, the India has partnered with a country. So which country is it? It is Netherlands. With Netherlands, India has partnered to set up the technological infrastructure, the digital infrastructure, which should be there in order to implement this national digital health mission. So we are already aware of the fact that in India, there is no technological advancement to that level that we can completely rely on digital sector to provide the health services. That is why in order to strengthen that technological sector, this partnership has been done, and under this partnership, e-health sector or the technological base of India will be strengthened. So that is the main purpose of this partnership. That's all for the first question. And now, okay, so I have forgotten one thing, the static part of Netherlands. So what is the static part? Capital, currency and prime minister. So these are the three things, these are the three questions, that is your homework for the day. You have to tell me the answers of all the three questions mentioned here. Now let's discuss the second question, which is which of the following airport has will become the first aerotropolis of India. Now first of all, what is the meaning of aerotropolis? You would be thinking right? So aerotropolis word has been made from two words. Aero is airline or aviation, and tropolis is a region. So what is the main idea behind calling aerotropolis or behind calling a region aerotropolis? The main idea is that the region derives its basic economic activities, or the economic activities of the region is derived from the airplane or the airline or the aviation sector which is present there. So that is the main idea behind aerotropolis. Like we have metropolis. So what is the main reason of calling a region metropolis? The main reason is that the major economic value of that region is contributed by metro, is facilitated by metros, like we have in Delhi, Mumbai, Kolkata. So similarly, the aerotropolis would be a region where the economic activity, majority of the economic activity will be derived by the airlines. So which airport is it going to be? It is Jawahar International Airport. Now this Jawahar International Airport will be located in, will be developed in Gautam Buddh city, Gautam Buddh district, sorry, in Uttar Pradesh. So basically this Jawahar region will become the aerotropolis. Now this Jawahar International Airport is also known as Noida International Airport. That's the first fact. The second fact is that this airport is being developed or is being constructed in association with Zurich International Airport. So this fact is quite important, that it is with the assistance of Zurich that this international airport will be developed, and it is going to be the first aerotropolis of India. Do remember these facts. These are very important for the examination. So now we have the third question, which is which state will cultivate hing for the first time in India? As I have mentioned in the beginning itself that till now hing was not produced in India, it was only imported. What is the reason for that? The reason is that hing can only be cultivated in the very cold and dry regions like Ladakh that we have. And in India, there are not many regions which are as cold as as conducive for the hing, which is also known as asafoetida. So in order to fulfill the consumption needs of Indians, hing was imported till now. And right now, the institute, that is CSIR's Institute of Himalayan Bioresource Technology, has taken this initiative to cultivate hing for the first time in India. Now this institute is located in the same state in which hing is going to be cultivated. So the state is Himachal Pradesh. quite easy. From the options itself, you can also make a guess. As I have told you that cold and dry regions. So that is why Himachal Pradesh is the most apt place where the hing can be cultivated. And the institute which is going to cultivate it is also located in Himachal Pradesh. That's the minor fact that you should keep in mind. So that's all for this news. There is nothing much to discuss here. This is a one-line fact that you have to keep in mind. Let's move on to our next question. So National Dairy Development Board has launched a call center for dairy farmers to address their queries on animal health, nutrition and productivity. Quite easy. The purpose is, then what is the name of the call center? So what is the name? Can you make a guess here? The name is Pashu Mitra. Quite easy name it is. Pashu is animal, Mitra is friend. So the call center is named as animal's friend, that is Pashu Mitra. And what would be the purpose of this Pashu Mitra? To provide guidance to farmers, to dairy farmers, about animal nutrition, animal health and productivity. Quite an easy question it is, but now my question for you is that you have to tell me who is the chairman of NDDB. This is the static news. This is the static portion of this news that we need to cover. So you have to tell me that. And now let's discuss our next question. So the next question is, recently India has invited Australia to participate in a naval exercise along with Japan and USA. What is the name of that exercise? Quite an intriguing question it is, because it is asking you the name of the exercise in which India has invited Australia. India also conducts the same exercise with Japan and USA. So what is the name of that exercise? Guys, this exercise has been in the news for quite a long period of time. So I hope that majority of you should know the answer. The answer is Malabar. Malabar exercise is the naval exercise that India conducts with Japan and US till date. And right now for the 2020 edition, India has invited Australia for participation in this Malabar exercise. Now guys, the other fact that is there is that India plus Japan, USA and Australia, these four countries are Quad countries. Now what is Quad group? I have told you in one of the previous sessions of Morning Tales itself that what is the Quad group, when was it formed and what is the purpose of this group. So I'm not going to tell you the details again. You have to tell me that when is this Quad group formed, so that I also get the idea how much are you following the current affairs and how much can you detail. So you have to tell me the Quad group. Formation date of Quad group. Now, next question is, which has become the first country in the world to implement the facial recognition for availing the government's online services? Quite an easy question it is, but important as well, because it is the first country in the world. So which country has done so? It is Singapore. Singapore has implemented this facial recognition system in order to avail the government schemes under SingPass. Digital scheme. So this is the name of the scheme under which this facial recognition recognition requirement has been made mandatory by Singapore government. Now, if we have talked about the current part, now we should also look into the static part of this news. So the static part is, again, capital, currency and PM. Now for a change, I will be telling you the capital and currency of Singapore. You have to tell me the PM of Singapore. Do remember this thing, in 2020 itself, the PM has been elected, and the person who has been elected is serving his third term as Singapore PM. So you have to tell me in the comment section that who is this person. Now what is the capital? Capital is Singapore itself and currency is dollar. Quite easy to remember these facts, because there is nothing much effort. The name of the city and the capital city and the country is the same, and currency is dollar. Let's move on to our next question. So the next question is, who heads SEBI's market data advisory committee formed to ensure that market data is available or is made more freely accessible to all? First of all, let's discuss the purpose of this market committee. So this market data committee has been formed in order to make data, securities market data, more accessible to the people, to the investors and customers. Now, why is the need of this committee? The reason is that securities markets data is not available so easily, is not accessible to the people, to the investors basically, or the participants of securities market. So in order to make it accessible and to provide data security and take care of data privacy, this committee has been formed. Now, who is the chairman of this committee, chairperson of this committee? So it is Madhavi Puri. So she is the chairperson of this committee. And what is the purpose? It's quite easy from its name itself, Market Data Advisory Committee. So this is to make the data more accessible for the people. That's all about this question. Now my question for you is, the head of SEBI. Do tell me in the comment section below. Recently the head has got an extension in his tenure. So you have to tell me that who is the chairman of SEBI. And let's discuss the next question. Who has been appointed as a chairman of Indian Banks Association for the term 2020-2021? First, let's discuss what this Indian Bank Association is. Now guys, you know that banks are regulated by RBI. So what is the purpose of this IBA? IBA is a group, is an association of banks and financial institutions, and this organization deals with the generic industry level queries of banks as well as financial institutions. So this is the purpose of IBA, and the chairman has been recently elected. So who is the chairman? It is Rajkiran Rai Ji. Now Rajkiran Rai Ji is also the MD and CEO of Union Bank of India. Do remember these facts because they are very relevant from the exam point of view. So this much is for this question, and let's move on to our next question. So here comes the news from sports section. So who has won the Denisa Denmark Open 2020 in men's single category? First of all, you should know that this Denmark Open is a badminton tournament. And which organization organizes this badminton tournament? BWF, Badminton World Federation. So Badminton World Federation has organized this Denmark Open 2020. And who is the winner in men's category? It is Anders Antonsen. So he is the winner in men's category, and he is also from Denmark. So his nationality is Danish. Again, I say this thing repeatedly that you have to pay attention to the minor details as well. So this is the minor detail, the nationality of the player. You should also keep this thing in your mind. Now we have talked about men's winner. We should also look into women's winner. So the women's winner is Nozomi Okuhara. From the name itself, it is very indicating. The name is very suggestive that the nationality of this player could be Japan. So she is a Japanese player, and she has won the women's event at the Denmark Open 2020. So these are the facts from this news, and we are heading towards the last question of the day. So the last question is, which football club has won the I-League 2019-2020 trophy? So I-League is India's indigenous football league, and we also have football leagues like La Liga, the Champions League, Premier League. So these are the very famous football leagues which are there in Europe, and in India we have our indigenous football league which is named as I-League. So which football club has won this? It is Mohan Bagan. This football club is in Calcutta. or Kolkata, as you want to pronounce it. So this club has won the 2019 to 2020 I League trophy, which is a football trophy, football league of India. So here our session comes to an end. I hope that you have really liked this session and you have found the information fruitful. And if you have, then do like this video and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell notification. Thank you so much for watching the video.